Welcome to this quick video tutorial on SGD's ghostlib mapper. Have you ever wanted to analyze sets of genes and identify their common functions, biological processes, or cellular locations? Well, the ghostlib mapper tool uses Gene Ontology or Go annotations to do just that. You can find the ghostlib mapping tool using the purple toolbar that runs across the top of most SGD web pages. Just mouse over the Analyze button, scroll down, and click on Ghostlib Mapper. The ghostlib mapper identifies higher level branches of the ontologies common to a list of genes based on their Go annotations. These higher level terms represent the major branches of the ontology, also known as ghostlib terms. Slim because they represent a pruned, simplified version of the ontology. This kind of summarizing can be useful when reporting results from a large-scale genomic studies. Step 1. Enter your gene names. To get started using the ghostlib mapper, enter your gene names of interest in step 1, separated by a return or space. Or if you have your genes already saved in a text file, you can just upload that file instead. Note that it needs to be in a .txt or .tab format. Step 2, choosing your go set. These are the terms that you will use to bin or categorize your genes. There are several types of ghostlibs, all created for different purposes. Here in step 2, you can choose, for example, the yeast process terms or the generic process terms. The difference between these is that the generic set is relevant to all organisms, while the yeast set of terms is specific to yeast. You can also choose to search against the macromolecular complex slim, which is a set of all macromolecular complex Go terms that have been associated with yeast genes. Step 3, refine your list of Go slim terms. If you don't want to use all the terms in the Go set you selected in step 2, you can refine or limit your list of terms to use only the ones you are interested in. If you do want to use all terms, just click Select All. Once you have made all your selections in step 1, 2, and 3, you're ready to go. Just click on the search button to see your results. The results table lists matching term names, the number of genes in the query list that map to each term, the number of genes in the entire yeast genome that map to each matching term, and a list of genes in your original query list that map to each term. If you'd like to take your results with you, click Download to generate a spreadsheet containing the information shown on the page. If you have any further questions or suggestions, please contact us at sgd-helpdesk@list.stanford.edu.